Okay.
You thought I was gonna come in crazy. I'm not, but I'm gonna go over everything, guys. We're gonna talk about our 3-week reintroduction to CrossFit. If you've been out of it for a while, like I have, doing these goat workouts, which are super hard. If you haven't done them, you're missing out. We're gonna try and get reacclimated to a barbell and the gymnastics up on the pull-up rig. So let me walk you through this as slowly as I can possibly do it. First thing, when you guys come in, remember to bring a workout towel. You need to have a workout towel. Most gyms are gonna require it. We're gonna require it. If you come in your first day and you don't have a workout towel, boom, first one's on us, no big deal. Just put your name here. Second one, forget it, it's $2. Just bring your own towel. We don't wanna charge you guys $2 for a towel. That's stupid, right? So if you guys come in, if you have been to class, we're gonna go grab a dumbbell if we need dumbbell or kettlebell. Otherwise, we're just gonna go to our station because the rest of your equipment is gonna be there waiting for you. So I'll, you know, figure out how to get there. I'll make my way over to my box. My box is gonna have a barbell and enough weights for me all week long. So once I go through my door, right, into my box, men's bar, got it squared away, 45s, 25s, 10s, and 5s. So I've got enough weight here to do my front squatting from the floor, right? I gotta clean it up. My strict press and some slow deadlifts. Maybe I'll need some more, but there's enough equipment to go around. We can make that happen. Now, once I'm in my box, I can stay here all day. I've got my spray bottle, I've got my workout towel, I've got a PVC pipe, we're good to go. Week one, we're gonna primarily focus on the barbell movements, body weight stuff, kind of transitioning from go to CrossFit. When we get into week two, we'll start seeing more stuff on the rig. So we'll get into more pull-ups, rig rows. We'll try to keep the RX individuals that can do pull-ups here on the rig, the other, or close to the rig. The other stations will do something different. And I'll give you an example here in a moment. We've got some new setups for the rig rows. So we got these different straps here, so they're consistent. They'll be a lot easier for you guys to set up. You don't really have to adjust them. You just throw them on. They're at one setup for ring rows or dips, and we're good to go. When I get into week 2 and 3 and I'm doing those pull-ups, we have a workout somewhere, I think it might be week 3, where we're gonna do burpee pull-ups. So the athletes that can do pull-ups, we'll keep them close to the pull-up rig or pull-up bars. Those of you guys that are scaling it down, we'll do something like a down up to a renegade row. So you'll still get a good upper body pull, but we won't have to be crowding around the rig. And if you're not doing pull-ups yet, this is a great way to get that upper body pulling stimulus. When we get into week 2 and week 3, we're gonna be programming more rowing, biking, as well as running. So we'll have some options. We're gonna try to make it clear that it's your workout, go with what you want. There's really no RX here, it's just a stimulus. So some of you guys might be riding a bike, some of you guys might be rowing, some of you guys might prefer to go run. So you'll have your option. Now we'll have 16 stations, right? Because we have 8 rowers, 8 bikes. So really it's pick what you want. If you prefer to run, great. If you don't really care, just let everybody pick what they want and then do the other, right? So we got everything in the appropriate station. Same as these stations here, we'll have your bar weights here. I could do my work on my barbell here with my rower or my bike, and again, with my run. So the flow is pretty straightforward. This will help us minimize any kind of transition time and spacing, right? So we're being a little bit thoughtful of that, but we're also trying to be efficient with your time. So we can have a 60-minute class condensed down to 45, 50 minutes without having to move everything around. We think we might be able to stick with something that might make your experience even better. So we'll see how that goes. What else, Brenda?
That's it.
June jorts, right?
June jorts.
Last thing, guys, June jorts is coming up and we're all out of shape. Admit it, you are, I am. No one wants to do it in front of everyone. So our registration, as you can imagine, is a little short this year. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna postpone June jorts to June 27th. We still wanna have it in June. This will back up a week after our 3-week reintroduction. So I think everybody will be a lot more capable of getting into the competition scene. Have a good time. We'll have barbecue, food, beer, all that good stuff. We'll have it at Redland. So we're gonna postpone that to June 27th, which is a Saturday, of course. Hopefully you guys can make it. For those of you guys that registered for the 6th, if the 27th is a problem, reach out to me, shoot me a text, send me an email. I'll refund you the $25, no big deal. I'm excited to have a barbell in my hand. It's been 10 weeks, I think, since I've actually touched the barbell, except for moving them in and out of the gym. So I'm ready to get after it, guys. Let's do it.